Army awarded Bell Textron a $1.3 billion contract for the helicopter that will replace the aging Black Hawk. The V-280 Valor tiltrotor beat out Sikorsky Boeing's bid for the Defiant X coaxial rotor blade platform in the years-long competition to design the future long-range assault aircraft, or FLRAA, a key part of the Army's plan to modernize its aviation platforms. An initial $232 million obligation will fund Bell's preliminary design and development of a virtual prototype, which the Army will then use to proceed with the acquisition over the next 19 months. Army Brig Gen Robert Berry, Program Executive Officer for Aviation, told reporters at a media roundtable. He stated that no aircraft will be purchased during the first phase of the acquisition. The competition pitted two approaches against each other. Bell Textron's tiltrotor design, which is similar to the V-22 Osprey flown by the Marines, Special Operators, and the Navy, and Sikorsky Coaxial Boeing's rotor blade, which is a pair of rotor blades stacked on top of each other. Berry declined to elaborate when asked what set the tiltrotor apart from the competition. "We're not going to go into specifics about the evaluation," he said, "but what we were looking for was the best value approach." He defined best value as a complete analysis of a number of factors. "Nothing really drove the decision," he explained. "So at a high level, the factors or variables of performance, cost, and schedule were all considered, and the combination of those was explicitly defined and evaluated. While the V-280 is the best choice to replace the UH-60 Black Hawk, officials have planned for a possible protest from the Sikorsky Boeing team and accounted for that in our timelines," according to Doug Bush, Assistant Secretary of Defense. While the companies have 3 days to request a debrief, it is unclear whether Sikorsky Boeing will file a protest. "We remain confident that the Defiant X is the transformational aircraft that the United States Army requires to accomplish its complex missions today and in the future," Sikorsky Boeing representatives said in an email statement. "We will evaluate our next steps after reviewing Army feedback." Bush added that the Army is confident in its assessment. "The diligence was not solely for the purpose of avoiding potential protests. We wanted to make sure we got the right aircraft for the Army," he explained. "This isn't just a protest issue, and I'm confident in the process we'll use to get there." According to a Bell press release, the initial contract refines the weapon system design, sustainment, digital enterprise, manufacturing, systems integration, flight testing, and airworthiness qualification. Berry added that the total award amount for the FLRAA contract, including the engineering, manufacturing, and development phase, as well as the first lot of low-rate initial production, is $7.1 billion. "There's a larger number on the order of $70 billion of potential," he said, "depending on how many aircraft the Army procures over the long term, including potential foreign military sales. That's both short and long term." According to Keith Flail, Executive Vice President of Advanced Vertical Lift Systems at Bell, the V-280 will provide the Army with a modern rotorcraft. "For several years, the Bell team has demonstrated the exceptional operational capabilities, digital thread synergies, and platform affordability enhancements provided by the V-280, he said in the release. The V-280 platform is powered by a Rolls-Royce AE-1107F engine. Army Major Gen Walter Rugen, director of the Cross-Functional Team for Future Vertical Lift, added that the service is confident in the platform's ability to perform in degraded visual environments, which are becoming more common on the battlefield. "We are very concerned about the loss of visual reference in vertical lift systems, as well as the cognitive offloading that we would like to achieve in our future systems," he said at the reporters' roundtable. "We certainly see an ability to protect our crews in the future with a digital cockpit and full authority, digital fly-by-wire capabilities." When asked if the industrial base's health was taken into account in the selection process, Berry stated that the execution of any program would consider the suppliers and the suppliers' role in an industry prime. However, he claims that the winning platform was not chosen for this reason. "If your specific question was, is the choice between one or the other, then that is not the case," he explained. "That was not one of the considerations. The 1st Army unit will be outfitted with FLRAA by fiscal year 2030. According to the service, the initial prototype will be delivered to the Army by 2025.